Hi everyone, welcome you all. In our previous video of SelectorsHub, we have seen how we can install SelectorsHub plugin on Chrome browser and also seen how we can automatically generate different type of locators in SelectorsHub. Now in the today's video, let us try to explore some more features from SelectorsHub. And in the SelectorsHub, we can also create locators manually. We can also write manual locators and we can recheck whether the locators are correctly identifying the elements or not. So by default, the SelectorsHub will generate locators, XPath and CSS and so on. But apart from this, we can also generate or we can also write our own locators. So let us try to do that. So let me just open an application. And SelectorsHub I already installed. So let me just try to right click on inspect. Now we got the SelectorsHub tool here. So for example, let's say if you want to locate this element, normally we can just try to inspect this element. Let's say I'm inspecting search element. Now if I look at here, the locator is automatically generated here, relative XPath. Okay, and also it is generated a class name, absolute XPath, and a CSS and so on, right? So these are automatically all the locators have been generated. So if we want to create our own locator, suppose sometimes we don't want to generate, sometimes we want to write our own XPaths. So we can just off this option. So we can see turn off auto generated selectors. If we just turn off this option, so nothing is generated here. So as soon as you browse any option like this, nothing is generated. So this option, we can just help us. So we can just turn off, turn on, and automatically locators have been automatically generated. Okay. So if you want to write our own manual locators or XPath or CSS, then how we can do this? So simply, we can just make it is off or it will be on mode, no problem. You can have, you can make it off or on. In both the cases, we can create our own locators. So it will not have any problem. So let us try to inspect this search element. And now by default, it is generated some XPath here. But suppose I want to generate my own XPath. So simply what I can do is we can simply check the tag name. So here input is my tag name. So I can say slash slash input. And now it is matching with 11 elements. And among them, I want to exactly match with the search element. So if I look at here, there are multiple attributes are available, like name is available, class and other attributes. So let me take the name here. So I can say at the rate name equal to and the search, and when you press enter, now you can see this XPath is able to match that element, one element. So we can write our own XPath like this. And even if you off this option, turn off this option, still this XPath will able to find that element. Okay, so not only auto generated, we can also write our own locator. Suppose if you want to write my CSS for the same element, you can write like this. Suppose input is my tag name. And now I'm using one attribute to locate the element. Let's say I'm taking again name. So name equal to, I'll say search. So this will able to find that element. So you can write our own XPaths in SelectorsHub apart from this auto generation. And again, if you turn on this option, again, as usual, all the locators will be automatically generated. And not only this, the SelectorsHub also will help us by creating XPath access. So while writing the XPath, we can also include access. So XPath access is basically, suppose if you're not able to locate any element, and then we can first find the nearby element, and based on that element, we can find another element. So for example, we have a following and we have a preceding, following sibling, preceding sibling, ancestor, parent, child. These are all different type of XPath access. So those access information also automatically auto-suggested in the SelectorsHub. That is one of the feature. So for example, let's say I want to write an XPath which includes some XPath access. Okay. So now let us see how we can do this. So for example, let us take the same search box. Now I have written some XPath I'm returning here. Let's say I've written hash input at the rate name, at the net name search, sorry, it is an XPath, we need to say slash slash. So this is an XPath which is exactly identifying the search. But now by using this XPath, I want to locate the search button. I don't want to directly write an XPath for this search button. Let us assume this search button is not able to locate by using any other locator, right? So now I identified this search element, and by using this, I can identify or I can locate search button. So the search box is a nearby element for this search button, right? So by using this, I want to locate my search button. So how it is going to suggest access? So simply you can say search slash. As soon as you say slash, you can see here following sibling. So if there are any nodes which are available as a following siblings, it will show you this. Not only following sibling, it will also show you parent, ancestor, okay, and child, self. All other options will be shown. So here you can simply say following sibling. I'm taking following sibling. And if you look at this element, the tag name is called button. So simply specify the tag name of that element. Now it is exactly locating that search box. So this type of XPath access is also automatically generated. It will automatically give the auto suggestions. So we can select proper XPath access, and we can create our own XPath in Selector Hub. And not only this XPath access, which will also provide the XPath functions as a suggestions. So sometimes if we want to write a customized XPath, we need to include the XPath functions. And even those functions also automatically auto-suggested by Selector Hub. So for example, let's say here, I want to locate a MacBook, or I want to locate this iPhone. So let us try to write our own XPath with the XPath functions. So what I can do is, let me try to access this, or let me try to locate this by using text function. So how Selector Hub is suggesting the functions, let me show you. So if you locate this element, so currently there is an anchor tag, right? So you can simply say anchor tag, let's say slash slash A. Now 76 elements are matching. Now exactly I want this link MacBook, so I can provide a property. So if I don't use any property, I'm using, instead of using a property, I can just use text function. Now you can see, as soon as you type something, or if you're, as soon as you started bracket like this, it is started giving all the functions. Like it will automatically suggest contains text, start with, end with. So what are the functions are supported in XPath? All the functions automatically suggested here. So now this time I'm trying to use text equal to MacBook. So this is a how we can just write our own XPath. So let me remove this one. So text equal to MacBook. Now this is exactly matching with that element. So the functions also automatically suggested by the Selector Hub. Suppose I want to locate this iPhone. So now I want to use some other function. Let's say along with the text, let me try to use contains also. So simply what you can do is, let's try to inspect this element. And now the tag name is A. So let me try to A tag name. Now this time I'm trying to use contains function. So let's say as soon as you write something like this, it will also show you all the contains methods, different flavors of contains methods. So now we can use contains like this. And what is the contains text? So I can use a text function like this, contains and text. And this is a iPhone. So now we need to properly end this bracket. So let me just remove this. And at the end, you can also remove this. Now it is exactly locating that element. So apart from the XPath access, it will also auto suggest all XPath functions in Selector Hub. So by using these functions, we can also write our own customized XPaths in Selector Hub. Okay, this is another beautiful function. And now if I look at the dev tools, right? So yesterday also we have seen how we can see the dev tools, and dev tools are basically provide all the HTML tag here. This is a DOM. And what are the elements are presented in the UI? So for every element, HTML code is associated, and that will be shown in the dev tools. So sometimes some people will try to get the locators from this dev tools. Now let us see what are the limitations in the dev tools, right? So why we should not get the locators from dev tools? So dev tools also will generate the locators, and same kind of locators, same kind of XPath CSS we can still write using dev tools. But that is not always recommended, because sometimes whatever XPaths and whatever we have written, they may not able to locate the elements properly or accurately. right? So it is always recommended to use SelectorHub. So let us see some differences, like when I use DevTools versus SelectorHub. So what are the things DevTools cannot accurately perform? Okay, so let us see them. For example, let me take another page, let's say google.com. So let's go to this page. Okay, sometimes DevTools may not correctly give accurate locators. Let me try this. Okay, so in this, let me try to search for an element. So let us say this is my search box. I just want to find this element. Okay, so what I can do is I can simply say inspect. Okay, so we can simply say inspect, and in the DevTools, I'm just searching for Control F. When I say Control F, you will get the search option in the DevTool, right? Now, if you want to find how many total number of links, right, which are present in this page, simply I can say //A. So it is saying 66, totally 66 links are showing in this, right? If I go to SelectorHub and simply say //A, now you can see how many are it is showing. So I say //A. Let me refresh once again. Okay, let me just cancel this. Okay, and go to CSS selector and simply say //A. Now 25 elements are exactly matching. Now you can see actually there are 25 links are there with anchor tag, but in the dev tools, if I look at in the dev tools, it is showing almost 66. Let me show you once again. So I can say Control F and say //A. Now you can see 66 total anchor tags it is showing. So basically DevTools, it is basically searching for the text, not exactly the tags. So that is the reason it may not give the accurate result sometimes. But in the SelectorHub, it will always check for the tags. Exactly, it will count the number of tags. So it will give you the right answer, which is 25. So like this, there are many scenarios. You can see a lot of mismatches between the SelectorHub and DevTools. So DevTools are not recommended every time to get the locators and to check the locators. So if even if you write the customized locators, you can just write it down in the SelectorHub and you can cross check whether it is properly locating the element or not. Okay, so searching of element is not always accurate when I use DevTools. And one more thing also, suppose if you write some XPath here, suppose let me identify any element here. Okay, and which is generated some XPath here. So this is able to locate the element. Let us try to locate the search box. Okay, so now this is a relative XPath, right? So this is able to locate the element. Suppose if you do any mistake while writing your XPath, if you do any mistake in this, it will automatically show an error. So when you press enter, it will clearly show invalid XPath. And also it will suggest to you what we should do. So close square bracket, which is missing. So whenever you do some incorrect XPath here, it will clearly show you invalid XPath, and also it will give you suggestion, then we can correct it. So this is an option which is available. Suppose if you do the same thing, right, in the DevTools search option, if you want to cross check, suppose I have missed something, then it will not give you any error. Okay, it will not suggest you anything. So it is better to use always SelectorHub. Whenever you write your own XPaths or your own CSS selectors, always paste them in the SelectorHub and then cross check whether it is correctly working or not. And if there is an issue in the XPath or CSS, it will automatically show you the error and accordingly you can correct it. This is one scenario. So other scenario is, for example, when I'm working with the shadow DOM elements. So when you're working with the shadow DOM elements, the DevTools cannot locate that shadow DOM elements. And especially shadow DOM elements, we always use CSS. XPath may not generate, XPath will not use. So CSS we have to write. So when I write a CSS for a particular shadow DOM element, your DevTools cannot recognize it. But still our SelectorHub will recognize that element, and also it will clearly tell that element is a part of the shadow DOM. So let me show you an example. So here I'm taking this page. Let me take this page. Now here, this particular search box is part of your shadow DOM, Okay, let me just highlight this element, and you can see shadow root. There are multiple levels are there. So these are all shadow roots. Inside this, this element is actually present. So this is basically an input element. So if I inspect this element, there is an input tag is there, right? So if I just go to the dev tools, now I'm searching for input. I'm writing the CSS for this. So when you're searching for the input, nothing is shown. It's not located anything and not even zero. So if there is an element within the shadow DOM, this cannot recognize this element. So when you use the same thing here, you can see here //input, it clearly says it is clearly XPath will not work, right? So CSS we have to use /input tag. So now you can see this clearly identifying that element. One element is matching. Also, it is clearly says it is a part of the shadow DOM element. Okay, this element is present inside the shadow DOM. It is matching with that element. But in the dev tools, you will not able to fetch that element and don't even know which is the part of your shadow DOM. Right, so there are so many areas we can find mismatches between these two. So instead of using dev tools, just try to use selector hub and where you can automatically generate the locators, or you can write your own customized XPath or CSS. And at the time of verification also, instead of using the search box dev tools, you can directly paste or you can directly write your CSS or XPath in this selector hub, and you can cross check whether it is properly locating the element or not. Okay, so these are the few more options which are available in the selector hub. So in the next video, we will discuss some of the features from selector hub. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.